My name is Labode Popoola. I'm a resource economist, forest resource economics to be precise. I've been teaching and researching forest economics and sustainable development for the past 30 years or so. And I'm the chair of the network in Nigeria. What do we intend to do? We intend to create, we intend to create a data platform for the 6 geopolitical zones in Nigeria. Nigeria is a very big country, perhaps as big as the UK and 2 other countries in Europe put together. And we want a situation where we can capture and harmonize all the data about development and put them in one bit, and also be able to have an interactive platform where we can actually compare development across the 6 geopolitical zones of the country. And this will enable us to evaluate development from time to time, even in the whole country. Nigeria has been around for a while, and we've been having development plans for some 50 years, close to 50 years now. But most of the time, there is a disconnect between these development plans and the actual development. And so we believe that if we are able to have a development pattern that will ensure that we capture all the data about development, it will be able to help us to connect with the citizens of the country. Now, we also expect that crafting an interactive platform for data decentralization across the geopolitical zone will also enhance development. We also know that there is a global support for implementation of the SDGs, and monitoring is key to this support. Now, initial worries when we attempted this project, we knew that we had insufficient time to conduct a countrywide study because of the size of Nigeria. And we also had a challenge in selecting the 6 states that we needed to use. And we asked ourselves some questions. First, on what basis will states across the zones be selected? There are 36 states and the capital territory making 37. So which of these states should we select? And how many people out of almost 200 million people are we going to interview to be able to get the information we require? Now, the stakeholders that we engaged in the process included local government chairmen. They are the lowest level of governance in the country. Traditional rulers, very influential people in the country. We also use sustainable development desk officers. These are relatively senior research personnel in the universities. We also used field assistants, early career researchers. We also used rural and urban residents across the different demographic groups. Now, lessons that we learned in the process, we had fairly wide differences between needs in rural and urban areas. Then we also had rural and urban residents who are willing to contribute to the process of sustainable development. And there were some surprises. The first one is that there was low level of awareness of the SDGs in rural communities and even in some urban centers, of course also in some universities. Available resources are not yet put in optimal use. Nigeria is a typical example of the paradox of plenty. So many resources, both natural and otherwise, but we have not been able to put it to very good uses. We also made some mistakes. Some of the initially selected states actually were similar in many circumstances, particularly in the area of social and economy. And we had to decide to use a more purposive selection process to be able to get the work done. Our early findings included the fact that the priority SDGs for northern Nigeria, particularly the rural and semi-rural areas of that zone, SDG 3, SDG 4, and SDG 8. In the southern part of the country, we discovered that SDG 6 and SDG 7 are priority. Now, this is not to say that the other SDGs are also not important. All of them are important, particularly SDG 1 SDG 2 and SDG 16. But these are the priority ones we decided on. Now, we, out of our respondents, males comprise about 66.43%, while females were about 35.57%. Now, the proportion of respondents between the ages of 18 and 25 were 18.88. Those between 26 and 49 were 62.94, and those over 50 are 18.18. Some of the discoveries included the fact that when conducting a needs assessment for a community, various sections of that population must be included. We discovered that quite late in the study. Now, this work also will provide a valid insight for government at different tiers on needed local support for actualization of the SDGs. And we also believe that researchers, NGOs, community-based organizations, civil society organizations will find our results very useful. Call to action. Support needed. In order to develop appropriate initiatives in each of the geopolitical zones, we think we will need about $1 million because of the size and population of the country and the complexity of that country also. And the takeaway from our effort is that the challenges are quite grave. For instance, at the moment, we have about 13.2 million children who need to be in school. They're already out of school. And for our next steps, work with states and non-state actors to advance the solutions through the identified needs. I want to thank you.